Welcome to Sudoku Dare, a Windows app made to challenge you. It's made to sharpen your Sudoku mind. In this tutorial, I'll show you how easy it is to use Sudoku Dare. But first, let's resize the Sudoku grid to match your comfort. As you resize the Sudoku Dare window, the grid is resized too. And if you don't like the colors of this app, go to the settings and choose another color scheme. When you are there, you might change other settings like the thickness of the Sudoku grid lines. The Sudoku you are trying to solve is automatically saved. As you start Sudoku Dare again, you can go on with your Sudoku. It's easy to enter numbers. You either use the mouse and keyboard, or you use the mouse only. No need to type a number if you don't want to. But I'll explain this later on, as the quickest and perhaps easiest way is to type numbers. Just hover above a cell with your mouse pointer and type a number. Or more precise, hover above a cell part and type a number. The center part is for the solved number, the number you're convinced is the right one. The upper and lower parts are for other numbers, for instance numbers which still can go in a cell, or numbers you just want to try. Now for entering numbers by mouse without typing. Again, just hover above a cell part, but now press and hold down the left mouse button. A small numbers window will pop up. While holding down the left mouse button, move the mouse pointer to the number you want to enter and then release the button. The number you have pointed to will appear in the cell part you have hovered above. Basically, this is how you enter numbers. But how to remove a number in a cell part? When you type or select by mouse a number which is already in a cell part, this number will be removed. You could also press the spacebar or the delete key to remove the center number or top and bottom numbers. Now it's time to begin to solve a Sudoku. Set your solving skill level and click the new button to get a new Sudoku according to the set skill. The solving timer will be reset to zero. And when you notice your Sudoku is faulty, you can restart it. After getting stuck, you might want Sudoku Dare to give you a number, but you get 30 seconds penalty for it. 30 seconds is added to your solving time. After you're convinced your Sudoku is right, hit the check button. Either you'll get the solved notification and the solving time will show your solving time, or the faults you have made are shown and the timer will continue. You may just want to see the solved Sudoku, especially when you have chosen a high skill level, but the solving time is reset to zero as you didn't solve it. As Sudoku Dare generates Sudokus, you probably don't want to enter one yourself. But what if you have found a Sudoku somewhere and you want to solve it? Click the Enter button and enter it in the empty grid. Then click the Start button to begin solving it. Although Sudoku Dare automatically saves the Sudoku you're solving right now, you may want to save a Sudoku to solve it later. After saving it, you can try another one. And if you want to work on the saved Sudoku again, click the Open button.